Hi, this is about an idea. When I first read about it, I was pretty convinced, but now I'm not sure. And the idea is donating your health data after death. And the aim behind that would be to help science and healthcare while also avoiding the risks that emerge when you have a giant health database. Did you know that good relations are better for your health than money or social status? Close relationships at the age of 50 are a better indicator for a long life than our genes or IQ. How do we know this? Long-term data collection. So they can really show things that take decades to show their effect. We all know that today we have very powerful data processing capacities. With the right training data, it was possible to develop a software that can warn of a high risk for a heart attack just by scanning the patient's retina. Now, think of your left knee. Imagine the kneecap popping out, and then maybe don't imagine the pain. You go to a doctor, and they tell you you need surgery, but you're scared. So you go see another doctor, and they tell you to avoid surgery. Wouldn't it be good to have a database where thousands of people would have donated their knee problem data, including their weight, how often they exercise, if they chose surgery or physiotherapy, and how happy they were with their life 3 months later, 5 years later, and so on. So, of course, there are risks in having such a big database. It is a big challenge to secure it. It's not easy to prevent leaks. If you look online, you will find many examples of health data breaches. So, in order to use data for our healthcare systems, we do need a system that we can trust. And otherwise, there are risks to be stigmatized. There are risks that you might not get a job if your diagnosis would suggest that you are not capable to do the work. And there are other risks. Because your health data contains can contain information about cancer, HIV, diabetes, psychiatric diagnoses, and so on. So we need this trust. And one way of generating trust is to reduce or eliminate risks. And that's basically what the idea of health data donation after death is trying to achieve. It's comparable to the system of organ donors. So here you have a German organ donor card. You would fill it in, carry it with you. And in a similar way, you could declare that after you die, your health data shall be used for science. Now, that would, of course, avoid a lot of risks because dead people don't need jobs anymore. They don't get stigmatized. They cannot be blackmailed. And GDPR doesn't apply to them, except maybe some national member states and have their own laws. But you get the idea. So you would avoid a lot of the risks while still reaping some benefits because your phone collects your location data. When you get up, when you go to sleep, you're so important, social interactions. Maybe how much you exercise, or maybe even you use an app to manage your medication. So all of this could be combined with your official health records after your life. Only when you die, then it will be uploaded. So this has the advantage that there's no big incentive for hackers to go after the centralized health records of dead people. Here you see an image of an empty honeypot. So you would just manage, right, like now, your own health data during your lifetime. Maybe you would make more updates because you would want to make a gift to science and future generations, but otherwise that would basically be it. So I was very convinced of this, and I thought, okay, sounds cool. But you would not benefit from this because you would be dead. Also, if there's something very interesting in your data treasure, nobody can ask you questions anymore, so that would limit the usefulness. And of course, it would be very slow. It would literally take a lifetime for every health record to arrive in the system. So the benefits to future healthcare ideas would really, flow in very slowly, like drop by drop, right? So there's a pun intended. There's another disadvantage. After a generation, the data really are a bit less useful because our parents and grandparents are exposed to different stress factors than we are. They are exposed to different toxins and germs. So here, this is a container that you would use to cough into when you had tuberculosis. I never saw one of those in my lifetime. Another thing that we have to admit is that we cannot cut the corners on all risks. If you have a genetic disease and you upload your health data even after death, this of course impacts your family. So this is generally a problem in data protection, but it also is a problem here. And then of course, after all these limitations to usefulness, we realize that it's also quite a big effort. How do we ensure that all the data we collect all by ourselves are comparable, that they are valid? Where would we store them when we keep losing our smartphones, when we keep forgetting the password for our cloud storage? So there are some challenges. Who would keep the data pool clean? Who would control who can upload what? Who would govern the access and make controls of this? So maybe if this system is in place, we have a trustworthy system. And then if we have a trustworthy system, there might be a lesser risk of data breaches. And in that case, maybe we can help patients while they are still alive. So in Germany, there was a recent study, a representative study, and 1/3 of the participants said that they would be willing to share their health data if it helps them with their own personal diagnoses. Now, I don't want to end with a conclusion on this. Maybe it does make sense in some terms, in some cases, to have this long-term data collection, but I also wanted to highlight that there are some challenges to this idea, and I leave the discussion to you. That was all. Thanks for listening.